With the grim work of recovering bodies from the wreckage underway, and the death toll expected to rise, crews labored Friday to lift, cut and dig through chunks of the 950-ton concrete bridge that collapsed over Tamiami Trail this week, killing at least 6 people and injuring 10 more. While rescuers worked through the day and night to clear the rubble, the Florida Department of Transportation said late Friday that 2 days before the bridge collapsed, the lead engineer responsible for the project had left a voicemail with an agency worker saying there was cracking in the structure. The FDOT worker did not receive the voicemail until Friday, the agency said in a statement that included a transcript of the message from Denny Pate with Fig Bridge Group, which engineered the structure. "Obviously some repairs will need to be done, but from a safety perspective we don't see that there's any issue there, so we're not concerned. Although obviously the cracking is not good and something's going to have to be, done to repair that," Pate said in the voicemail transcript provided by FDOT. Investigators with the National Transportation Safety Board said they have not yet independently confirmed the reported cracking and could not say what, if any, role it might have played in the catastrophic collapse. "Some amount of cracking is common in concrete construction. A crack in the bridge does not necessarily mean it's unsafe," Robert Axetta, the lead NTSB investigator, said during a briefing Friday night on the Florida International University campus. Fig issued a statement late Friday saying the firm would cooperate with investigators and was examining its own assessment of the cracking. "The evaluation was based on the best available information at that time and indicated that there were no safety issues. We will pursue answers to find out what factors led to this tragic situation, but it is important that the agencies responsible for investigating this devastating situation are given the appropriate time in order to accurately identify what factors led to the accident during construction." NTSB Chairman Robert Sumwalt said the investigation would take several more days while the recovery effort continues. He said the agency would focus on figuring out what went wrong, and how to prevent a similar catastrophe from happening again. "It was still uncertain how long it would take to recover the remaining victims and to clear Tamiami Trail, which remains blocked to all traffic." Miami-Dade Police Director Juan Perez said rescue workers had confirmed at least 5 bodies remain under the bridge, although that number could rise. Federal investigators also confirmed an earlier report from U.S. Senator Marco Rubio that bridge workers were tightening 2 tension cables inside a support truss located at the northern end of the structure. "The work was supposed to strengthen the truss," Rubio posted a message on Twitter shortly after leaving the scene of the accident late Thursday. "The cables that suspend the they were being tightened when it collapsed today. The cable tightening, along with the reported cracks, added to the growing list of issues that the NTSB will examine." Shortly after the bridge collapsed, local officials also reported the structure had undergone a stress test. "It's also too early to say what, if any, role that might have played in the failure. Beyond the cause of the collapse, more questions remain." U.S. Rep. Carlos Curbelo said he questioned why cars would be allowed to travel under a bridge undergoing a stress test. He said he spoke to experts about it and, "They have all told me they've never conducted stress tests on a bridge with anyone underneath." Florida's Transportation Department, in its Friday statement, said it never received a request from FIU or its contractors to close the road for stress testing. FDOT said it had issued a blanket permit allowing for 2-lane closures effective from January through April, and that per standard safety procedure, FDOT would issue a permit for partial or full road closure if deemed necessary and requested by the FIU design build team or its construction inspector. The NTSB's Sumwalt said the agency team of 15 investigators will be conducting their own probe of the collapse, independent of local authorities. He expected the agency work would begin Friday once rescuers have recovered all the victims. "Our entire purpose for being here," Sumwalt said, "is to find out what happened so that we can keep it from happening again." Federal safety officials are asking anyone who saw the bridge collapse to contact them via email at witness@ntsb.gov. While rescuers searched for the dead, and investigators documented the evidence in painstaking detail, Perez